Welcome back to another video. Have you ever wondered how Google Maps shows you the shortest and correct path while predicting the traffic conditions? Or how do e-commerce and entertainment websites such as eBay, Netflix or YouTube suggest products or videos that are most suitable for the user? More importantly, how do all of the mails in your inbox get classified into spam and ham? Well, all of this is possible due to machine learning. So what is machine learning? Well, this video will give you a basic idea about machine learning technology and its different applications. Please leave a like if you find this video useful and hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss any updates. Stay tuned. What is machine learning? Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence that provides computer systems with the ability to learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. This allows computer programs to learn automatically from the data without human intervention by extracting patterns from the given data. Let's look at the different machine learning methods to get a more detailed understanding. Machine learning methods can mainly be classified as supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. There is also a fourth type called semi-supervised learning, which is a combination of supervised and unsupervised learning and hence the name semi-supervised learning. Supervised learning. Let us consider the shapes, circle, triangle, and rectangle. Each shape has a different number of edges. The number of edges become the feature of a classification model. That is, if the model has 0 edges, it becomes a circle. If it has 3 edges, it becomes a triangle, and if it has 4 edges, it becomes a rectangle. The shapes, circle, triangle, and rectangle become a class label. The machine learning model then learns from this data by associating which features belong to which label. Now, if we give a shape 3 edges, the model will be able to identify it as a triangle. This process of using labeled data to train the model is known as supervised learning. The model then uses this learning to predict the output for a future or unseen data. Want to try out supervised learning on an image data? Head over to Teachable Machine Image and click on the link. You need at least 2 classes for training the model. Here, I'm going to train the model on car and bike images and then use an image which is not there in the dataset to make the model predict to which class it belongs to. You can either use a webcam to train the model on live images or upload images to the web page to train. I'm choosing to upload the images here. Class 1 will be cars and I'm uploading images of cars into the sample. Class 2 will be bikes and I'm uploading images of bikes into the sample. Now that we have uploaded the sampled images, we can train the model. Once the model is trained, we can test it by uploading an image. First, I'll upload an image of a car, and as you can see, it classifies the image as a car with 99% confidence. Now, I'll upload the image of a bike, and it classifies it as a bike with 100% confidence. Supervised machine learning models require less training data compared to other machine learning models and makes training easier because the results of the model can be compared to actual labeled results. The downside of supervised learning is that labeled data can be expensive to prepare, and there might be chances of overfitting or bias in the training data, which may not allow the model to handle variations in the new data accurately. Supervised learning can again be classified into 2 types, classification and regression. Classification is a supervised learning algorithm where the output has defined labels. The machine learning models that we discussed above are examples of classification algorithm. Regression is a supervised learning algorithm where the output is of a continuous value. Regression model predicts values closer to the actual output value and evaluates it by calculating the error value. Smaller the value of error, greater is the accuracy to the regression model. House price prediction models are an example of regression algorithm where the output of the model, that is, the price of the house, would be a continuous variable depending on various other variables. Unsupervised learning. Consider a dataset of images consisting of cars and bikes, but this time the images are not labeled. The algorithm takes in these images and identifies features in the images. It then groups them into separate clusters based on these features. This method of clustering unlabeled or unclassified data into different clusters using features extracted from the machine learning model is known as unsupervised learning. Unsupervised learning algorithms are used on datasets that are unlabeled or unclassified. Here, the algorithm is used to extract meaningful features needed to label, sort, and classify the data in real time without human intervention. Unsupervised learning is mainly used to identify patterns and relationships in the data that would normally be missed by humans. Unsupervised learning algorithms are used mainly for clustering and anomaly detection. Anomaly detection is used to identify unusual patterns in a dataset that do not behave similarly to the cluster and is used mainly for intrusion detection, health monitoring, and fraud detection. Let us now summarize the difference between supervised and unsupervised data. Supervised data deals with labeled data, less complex, goal is to predict the outcome, classification and regression, number of classes is known during input. Unsupervised data deals with unlabeled or unclassified data, more complex as they require large dataset to train, goal is to identify patterns and relationship in data, clustering, number of classes is not known during the input. Reinforced learning. To understand reinforced learning in simple terms, let us consider animal training. Animal training involves giving rewards to animals for desired behavior and not giving reward to the animal when the desired behavior is not achieved. This positive reinforcement training methods make the animal learn on how to behave in a particular environment. This is reinforced learning. Reinforced learning is a behavioral machine learning algorithm in which the software agents are trained by means of trial and error. That is, the agents are rewarded for positive actions and punished for negative actions. Using this method, the agent maximizes its right moves and minimizes its wrong moves, thus allowing the software agents to automatically determine the ideal behavior within a specific context in order to maximize its performance. An application of reinforced learning can be said to be in the gaming frontier. AlphaGo Zero was trained using reinforced learning, where it learned to play against itself on the board game Go. AlphaGo Zero could then outperform its previous version AlphaGo by winning 100 games to zero and exceeded all the older versions in 40 days. Another application of reinforced learning can be seen in the manufacturing industry, where the machine learns to pick items from one place and put it in another place. The machine gains knowledge of the environment by training itself by means of reinforcement and uses this knowledge to do the job with great speed and precision. I hope you got an idea about the different machine learning techniques. So here are some questions for you. Let me know your answers in the comment section below by commenting whether each of the following uses supervised or unsupervised learning. Gmail uses an algorithm that learns different keywords such as prize money, winner, etc. to filter out spam emails from the inbox. What type of machine learning is used over here? Google News is a news aggregator service developed by Google that provides a continuous flow of articles from different publishers and magazines. What kind of machine learning is used over here? Lastly, what kind of machine learning is used by Google Maps to predict the traffic and let us know the time required to reach our destination? Moving on, we see an increase in the use of machine learning technologies in today's era. What caused this to happen? With large amount of digital data being generated every second, along with the rise in processing powers of computer, analyzing and processing huge amount of data became easier than before. Hence, more and more companies start leveraging the power of data to make machine learning models more efficient. Let us now look at some of the applications of machine learning. Image recognition. Image recognition is a common application of machine learning. Image recognition is used to identify people, objects, places, etc. in an image. Automatic friend tagging suggestion by Facebook uses image recognition to identify and tag our friends from the photos that we upload. Another application of image recognition is in the use of medical imaging diagnosis. Machine learning can be used to screen X-rays, CAT scans, and other imaging technologies to identify and detect abnormalities in the image. Speech recognition. Machine learning technologies are widely used for converting voice instructions into text by various voice assistant systems such as Siri, Google Assistant, Alexa, etc. Traffic prediction. Google Maps uses real-time info from sensors in the phone, along with previous travel history to predict the traffic and suggest the best route available. Product recommendation. Ever wondered how we get all the similar products that you may be interested in on Amazon or any other e-commerce applications? Well, this is machine learning in action. The websites identify your browsing patterns and suggest similar product based on your interest. This is similarly the case with entertainment recommendation systems such as Netflix, YouTube, etc. The algorithm learns your interest based on the videos that you watch and suggests the videos that you may like. Spam detection. Machine learning algorithms use potential keywords to scan emails to identify if the mails are spam or not. So when a malicious email with any of the keywords are identified, the application automatically flags the email as spam and moves it to the spam folder. That brings us to the end of this video. Hope you got an idea about different machine learning technologies. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and hit the subscribe button as it encourages me to make more videos. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.